Welcome back. Bowling fans, week 11. This week in the draft league, coming at you live. The most exciting 15 minutes in sports entertainment. 7 days ago, I was with today's greatest athletes. I had to wait 7 long days to get back with these athletes. Real quick, I made a slight mistake last week. I omitted saying Happy Veterans Day to all the veterans out there, especially my dad, U.S. Army, and the rest of them. Never forget, Happy Veterans Day, and I hope you had a good week. Last night was the Staten Island Hall of Fame induction ceremony, where my co-host was the MC, and he is fantastic at it. Congratulations to all the inductees, but two in particular, Lou Gordio Jr. and Jeff Charest. Congratulations, and there goes Oscar Aranda. He owns Lowe's. He almost owns Lowe's right now. Major shareholder, Kenny. Getting back, Lou Gordio Jr. and Jeff Charest inducted, well-deserved, two of the best bowlers I ever bowled against and with in my career. And you probably heard a lot of quick stories about the two of them last night, but I got two real quick ones. Jeff Charest at the green in front of the Luster King machine with the red dots going down. Does anyone remember the Luster King machine? 9, 8. Jeff threw the ball in there. And then when it went down to 1, the door opens up like the ship from E.T. You remember? When it opened up and E.T. left with the smoke coming out, Luster King. A little kid went over and he was about to touch the ball. And Charest was like, oh, kid, what are you doing? My ball. That's my Charest story. Second up, Lou Gordio Jr. I was in Country Lanes one day with my good friend Ron Oliveri. Love you, Ron. He moved on us. One of my all-time teammates, Ronnie O. He was practicing, Lou Gordio, and he had a notebook. And after he made a shot, he was writing something down. He was writing down what board he hit. He was writing down the break point, and he was writing down the speed. So I said to Ronnie, that's what we got to do. So the next time I practiced, I brought paper and a pen. And guess what? After an hour of renting the lane, I never hit the same board or break point or speed twice in the hour. Never did it. So with 15 minutes to go, I said, you know what? Forget it. I just started doodling on paper like we all have in the past. And I even brought some of the doodles with me. Because there's no way I'm going to hit the same mark twice. So I said, you know what? Let's just start drawing. And I started drawing things that we all drew in our notebooks when we were young, especially Joe and Tony. I don't know about you guys. I know Kenny definitely too. If you were metal back in the day, I'm still metal. Tony's metal. This was written somewhere in your binder or notebook. That with the cross. Okay, so that's number one. That's coming up. Number two, this was written in your book when you were young, in the binder. Tone?
Yes.
Joe? Third, the graffiti name, Joe. I mean, I didn't color it, but pretty much. Pretty much. If you were born in the low 70s to mid 70s in high school, this was there.
Even the 60s. I was born in the 60s. All good. Yeah, all good.
All of you, I know this was in your book. This S was in your book.
There you go.
Tony. Yeah. And then on the other side, with the bolts. This was the steel version of the S. And last but not least, I hope you know this one. This is more on the girl side. But you know what? MASH. Was MASH in the book? Mansion, apartment, shack, house, four girls, the cars, Corvette, Pinto, limousine, Oldsmobile, kids on the bottom, MASH. In the comments below, admit that they were in your book. Intros coming up. Do you know if there was a cameraman draft, there would be a first pick? And that first pick will be none other than this man right here, number one pick, the Israeli intimidator, Matt Kaplowitz. Say hello.
Hello.
Second one up, is my man Ken Soto, always smiling. He loves the Kid Apps. Mr. 300, Mr. Pokemon, Kenny Soto. Last but not least, to my left, Brooklyn Zone, Staten Island Zone, Joe Calandrillo, also known as Joe Cal. Who do we got, Joe?
Well, tonight, folks, we got our special guest is our original cameraman, Tony the Hound Dog Everts. But before we bring Tony up, just want to give a quick shout out to Mr. and Mrs. Rob Butler for winning the Open Doubles Championship at Showplace last weekend. Rob asked for the shout out. We gave it to him. Hillary and Rob, nice job. Congrats. They get to go to the dinner, I believe, at the Staten in May. So nice job by them. And touching on the Veterans Day thing, I want to also say happy Veterans Day. Sorry we missed it to all the vets, especially to my dad, God rest his soul, World War II veteran, and to my brother Michael, a Vietnam veteran. And my Uncle Tony, a World War II veteran on the beaches in Normandy on that fateful day. But anyway, happy Veterans Day to all the vets. We love you all. God bless. And like my buddy Joe said, never forget. Anyway, never forget. Anyway, it's that time, folks. We're bringing in one of my buddies. He's a friend of the show. He's a friend of Rabs Country Lanes. He's a friend of the bowling community, Tony the Hound Dog Everts.
Thank you, sir.
What's up, brother?
Thank you.
There he is. The Hound Dog.
Let me just clear. I'm going to clear up a couple of things right off the bat, okay? As far as my involvement with the show goes, okay? The reason I am not manning the camera as much as I did at the beginning of the show was because I work a weird shift, okay? I work 11 to 7:30. So if I'm not here by 8, I can't get on the camera. My friend, Mr. Kenny Soto, has agreed to fill in, and he does such a great job. So I basically let him roll with it. Now, so I want to, that is the main reason why I'm not here every week to do the camera anymore. It's not because I'm rushing to get something to eat. I do eat sometimes before I bowl. I mean, we all eat dinner, right, before we bowl. So that's the thing. That's what I'm doing, and that's why I'm not on the camera anymore.
Tony had to clear that up. That was sticking in his craw all day today from when Johnny Wilders brought it up from the golf cart this morning down in Florida. Johnny, we saw the clubs in the back of the cart. I like it.
Does he drive anything else?
I don't know. Just the golf cart. I think he has license plates on that thing. He does, right? So, Tone, we're going to start off with a couple of, before I bring Joe back in for the off the cuff, I'm going to start with some bowling questions on a serious to get the bowling stuff going.
All right.
Okay, when you throw your favorite ball, your best reaction, are you throwing a pearl cover stock or a dull cover stock?
Most definitely a dull cover stock. Like Mo Pinnell once told me, shiny is no good for me, so I try to stay away from the shiny stuff, although in the last couple of years I've kind of incorporated into my arsenal a little bit. But the solids are better for me. Generally, symmetric solid usually works well for me.
Okay. Another one for you, which is pretty easy. Pin up or pin down?
Well, I've had success in the past with pin down because of my ball speed. Pin down tends to pick up a little faster than pin up, but Christian Ruiz told me that most layouts should be pin up. So with the newest ball that I drilled recently, the Matrix Solid by Ebonite, I went with a pin up drilling on that ball, and it reacts just fine.
Nice. Uh-oh, he's back, folks. Mike Orlando. We were looking on the back of milk cartons for this guy. He's back. We love you, Mike. And Tone, my last bowling question for you before I turn it over to my buddy Joe B. You were fortunate enough to win Jim Elliott's New Year's Singles Classic in 2010. It's a major.
Yes.
We're all still very proud of you for that. Even eight years later. Now, the question is, we know you took down Don Pendleton, who's a perennial finalist every year in that tournament, I think since Jimmy Carter was president. The guy's been in the finals every year, okay? Makes the cut every year. You took him down. But along the way, which match did you win where you felt, I really got a chance to win this thing? Against who?
Definitely against Sean McAuliffe, which was the match before Don Pendleton, because I had the front six. He had the front six. I don't know. I beat him like 250 to 240 or something like that. And definitely that match gave me a lot of confidence to think maybe I could win the last one too.
He did. Okay. Now, we finally got a question from the audience. I got a text at work today from none other than last week's guest, Tommy McGrone. Tommy said, Joe, do the bowling community a big favor. Ask Tony, is it Tony Everts or is it Tony Everts? Now, I know the answer. We know it, but Tony, right. Mike has known Tony since they were like little kids running around in a schoolyard. But Tony, I think I know the answer, but we're going to let you clear it up.
Yeah, I've only heard Everts said a couple times maybe in my life, so it's definitely Everts. Yeah. Tony Everts, like Chris Everett with an S at the end.
That's it. And in closing, before I turn it over to Joe B., I want to say this guy, one of my best friends and one of my best teammates.
Oh, yeah.
Right here.
I just want to give a shout out to the Nudop girls bowling team today, winning the title again and being undefeated.
Yes.
I'm wearing my beads in support of them. Back to back. They won today. They beat Tottenville. My daughter Allison shot 237 today. The A team shot 927. So they put the hammer down today, and I'm very proud of them at Showplace.
That's a great job by the Nudop girls. Tony. Pleasure, brother. Joe B., take it away.
Yes, congratulations to my friend Allison, 237.
Good job, Allison.
That's called lighting it up.
Good job.
In a big spot. Tony is also one of my best teammates, too. I figured I'd switch gears, Mike.
I got a business.
Oh, yeah, go do that. Now, who has the best shot at winning a championship? Mets, Rangers, or Jets, without getting mad. Just, like, let's just say, like, who's the closest, who's the furthest?
I am going to say the Mets are the closest, and the Rangers are the furthest. And it's they're all similar, but I feel like the Mets, I don't know, they were there more recently, and the Jets are just, they're kind of a hopeless situation, but they have a young team, they have a lot of money, they're going to get another high draft pick. So you just have to hope it clicks one year. But that's the order I would say.
Okay. In terms of music, give me the top three bands or artists in the Tony Everts collection.
Top three. It's going to be tough. I'm going to say The Police are one of them. Tough. I'm going to say Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers,
all right, okay.
And Elton John.
Three good names.
Hi, Jacqueline.
By the way, I think I turned him on to the Police. Can we admit that?
You did. Yes, that's true. I liked them, but was never a huge fan until I bought all this stuff.
In fact, the intro music tonight is the Police. Now, what's the chances of that? For real. Okay. No, it's off synchronicity. Okay. So, next up, Laverne and Shirley or Happy Days?
Happy Days, no doubt about it. Not even close.
Okay, how about Knight Rider or A-Team? The A-Team.
Neither one.
Wow.
Love Boat or Fantasy Island?
Oh, that's close. I'm going to say Fantasy Island.
Dynasty Dallas or Falcon Crest?
Dallas.
Bon Jovi or Motley Crue?
Bon Jovi.
Oh, what? Are you serious with that one? Oh, boy. All right. How about Maiden or Priest?
Maiden.
Quick tidbit. I asked that to Mike Piazza one time. Mike Piazza was walking by all the people, you know, Mike, for autographs. In Port St. Lucie. So everybody's hanging on the thing, and Mike Piazza is walking away. He's strategically walking 20 feet away up the left field line to make believe he don't hear anybody. So one of the kids catches his eye, and he walks over, and I happen to be 5 feet away. And they're like, Mike, how many home runs are you going to hit? Sign this, sign my shirt, sign my face. By the way, I hate autographs. Hate them. I don't. If he walked through the door right now, I wouldn't even ask him for a friggin' pen. So I said, Mike, Maiden or Priest? And it was like, oh, finally. Hey, what's up? How you doing? Came over and he likes Judas Priest. Started talking a little music, but that's the point. You know, he's sick of talking baseball. He wants to talk music. You know that. Christmas or Thanksgiving?
Christmas.
I agree. Okay. And we went over this the last time. Did I catch this from you? Your first car.
My first car was a Dodge Dart that my father owned that he gave to me. That was my first car.
Yeah, Dodge Dart comes up a lot, you know, because that was the Honda Accord. Yes, sir.
I got a special interview. Can I do a special interview?
Yeah. Sure. He's going to get the mic, but I'm going to say, Tony, this guy is the reason why leagues keep going, and this guy, and this guy, and this guy, and this guy, but especially Tony. There's no leagues if there's not people like me and Tony and Joe every week. You understand that, Kenny? And Kenny Soto. Without us, there's no league.
That's right.
Remember that.
That's right.
We are the middle class of bowling on Staten Island.
He ran away.
He ran away.
As soon as he saw the camera, he left.
We are the middle class bowlers, and he's probably at the top of the list in terms of where should the leagues be going? How should the money be distributed? The rules of the leagues. Big rules guy right here.
Yep.
And you know what? If there's no rules, you know what happened? Anarchy. That's what happens. Tone, give me one thing going forward that you like to see, not in this league particular, but moving forward with our sport. Let's go.
Less subs on a weekly basis. How about that? Less subs. When you join a league, you can. Now, I didn't feel this way back in the day when I bowled five-man league, but now with the triples, I'm, you know, it's definitely more. I think about it more. When you join a league, you sign up to bowl 36 weeks. If you're not going to be here every week, then you shouldn't even be bowling in a league. That's just my opinion. And I don't like the amount of subs that are here every week in the draft league. But it is what it is. And it's never going to change. So, but
yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. There's like four or five super subs, by the way. But, you know, that's what it is.
Okay. Hey, the reason why we did it is because Tony's not afraid to say what's on his mind. And guess what? Give him credit for that. I give him credit for that, right, Gio? Right, Gio?
Mikey G in the house. Yeah, that's it.
It's that time. Sponsor time, Country Pro Shop, Gennaro's Pizzeria with Marco, Lowe's Bowler of the Week. We figured it out. I got the word. I got the email from Lowe's.
Junior.
And it's up, Junior.
John Baranello, Junior, one of the best golfers on Staten Island.
The Lowe's Bowler of the Week is going to be a second-time winner. It's our second... Second time winner. And let's not let this happen again.
Yes.
My teammate, Rick Nora, 522. He gave me the scores, but.
Also known as Dr. Phil.
Also known as Dr. Phil. But guess what? He gets a pass because we won last week, despite it. And I love you, Rick. And you know what? Next week is week 12, which is going to be the last week of the first trimester or third.
Right.
Then we're drafting again. And you never know. And you go ahead. Here you go. And you never know.
As a matter of fact, as far as my involvement in the show, I do 90% of the scheduling. So I want to throw that out there. Next week, you have Matt Peduto and Rolando Graham. The week after that is the draft. So obviously no show. The week after that, you have Ira Levy and Steve DiMaria.
Oh, boy.
Now, if you want to get on the show, come and tell me. I'll set you up. You know, we are going to repeat guests, obviously. And what is the deal between Mike and Rick? Can somebody clear that up for me? What happened with that?
I'll tell you what happened with it real quick. Mike's a funny guy, like us. We like to have fun. Some people are too serious. Okay? Listen, bottom line, we suck. You understand it? It's fun. We love our guests, and the bowling community wants to know from the future guests, and this man goes out and gets them. Joe, send us off. I need practice. I'm terrible.
Folks, it's almost time for us to go practice, but I just, guys, can we get a quick shot of the what's going to be Christmas wreath? Here's a Christmas wreath. We got some Christmas stuff. Folks, Thanksgiving is 3 days away, so I wanted the guys to get a shot of this because I want to say happy Thanksgiving. The holiday season is upon us. Everybody have a great day on Thursday. Eat, drink, watch football, have fun. A salute. We'll see you next week. Tony, New York girls, and the Wagner boys. Congratulations.
Sit, boo-boo, sit. Good dog.